cybersecurity threats.
Cybersecurity has become really dangerous.
They're all around us. Phishing attacks, ransomware attacks.
There's no way that you can prevent the attack. They will go after you as long as you want to use the internet. Just like, you know, the safest way to protect that is not to use the internet. And that's not going to happen.
There are options, though. Computer security software, for instance, which scans your system and tells you whether your files are safe or infected, often notifying you with a message in a pop-up window. But for users like Kyle Steinle, who rely on screen readers like this,
you are currently on web content.
There's a security gap.
I became blind back in 2002, so I was born sighted. My screener's not going to be saying when every image changes on the screen or up in the toolbar or anything like that. Most of the World Wide Web and most programs on the computers, they are not designed for blind users to use them. It's more, think of a third-party application to make things accessible. But even then, it's still very much limited.
A lot of what we do as sighted individuals, when we sit down and we're using the computer, we're not quite sure if this is a phishing email or this website is kind of a scam. We use a lot of visual cues. A lot of the information that a person who is not visually impaired would use to understand cyber threats is just simply not available to people who are visually impaired.
So a team of Texas Tech researchers set out to find a solution for Kyle and the thousands like him, living with a visual impairment in a world that revolves around the web.
It becomes very difficult even for the scanner reader to actually translate what is going on in terms of the cybersecurity attacks. They need some sort of assistive technology to inform them and to inform them of the potential attack.
With funding from the National Science Foundation, the team turned to sound, translating those visual warning signs into something the user could hear.
We started out with a pool of around 50 sounds, and we had 9 basic ideas of threats when we first started. We assign a sound to that attack, depending on the severity and the risk involved. We wanted to be able to come up with the best representation of those threats orally.
It's called sonification, using audio to relay information. In this case, a possible cybersecurity threat.
We want something that will stand out and give the user an idea of what's going on.
Phishing rod becomes very equivalent to the phishing. So if you use the phishing rod sound, that can represent a phishing attack.
We have a window breaking for someone like breaking into your files. We added an announce sound at the beginning, a little bell, so that they would know that something was coming.
The group considered using both artificial and natural sounds, finding that sampled natural sound best conveyed the consequence of a particular threat.
How many of these can people memorize and still get the message that you're looking for? Because there are limits in terms of people's abilities to understand those kind of warnings. There's sort of the psychological aspects of what is this sound? Why does it have this sort of natural connection to a certain meaning? How readily do people pick that up?
More of linking the sound to what's going on, not just having a whole new list of sounds to memorize what these sounds mean.
We find that people tend to be more adaptive and use familiar things than if they have to do a lot of study to learn something that doesn't make a lot of sense to them at the beginning.
The team hopes to continue its work, advancing the technology to make the internet a safer place for all of us.
The problem is not just focused users who are visually impaired. The problem is every single person.
We're hoping to level the playing field again for people who are sighted. Many times you get little clues by the layout of a web page or by a graphic that doesn't look quite right. And when a non-sighted person is reduced to listening to a page reader, that level of discrimination doesn't exist.
There's a social impact to the project. There's a technical impact to the project.
And we are hoping that we can actually take it to the next level, like I think we call it transition to practice, for the commercialization purposes, and hopefully the technology can be helpful for the users who are visually impaired.
For Texas Tech Today, I'm Allison Hirth.